These are legitimately the top five fish that you should be eating on a ketogenic diet. This isn't just some basic list, okay? This is scientifically backed based on omega-3 profiles, based on mineral content, and also based on how easy it is to truly get the stuff. I'm not gonna just recommend some obscure type of fish. Okay, so let's get right down to it and break down the science of why we're choosing specific fish and why fish on a ketogenic diet is so powerful for fat loss and for overall feeling good in the first place. But hey, you're locked into the internet's leading performance, nutrition, and fat loss channel with new videos every single Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday at 7 a.m. Pacific time and a bunch of other videos in between as well. Okay, so fish is phenomenal on a ketogenic diet for a multitude of reasons. Probably the most obvious one is going to be the higher fat content, right? Of course, the keto diet is a very fat-based diet, so if we can have more fats coming in from healthy fish, then we're obviously putting ourselves in a very advantageous situation with having fats as a fuel source. Now, additionally, they're very easy to break down, okay? Mechanically, fish is easier to digest. So it's just easier. You have a higher likelihood of extracting the amino acids from the fish that you eat than you would from another protein source, simply because you're probably gonna chew it more thoroughly and it's gonna break down in your system easier. There are a bunch of other benefits too, but the main thing that I wanna focus on is going to be the omega-3 profiles. Okay, I have to spend a minute or so explaining why omega-3s are so critical on a ketogenic diet. We all hear it all the time, right? Omega-3s are great, omega-6s are bad, but on a keto diet, it's even more important that we pay attention to this. You see, you are a fat-based machine. Fat is your fuel right now. So that means on a ketogenic diet, that the whole omega-3, omega-6 profile and balance becomes even more important. Because if your primary fuel source is the wrong kind of fat, then you're gonna have an exponentially negative effect on your body. So it's very important. Okay, so with omega-3s, we should be sitting at a 1-to-1 ratio generally. But here in the Western world at least, most of us are sitting at a 20-to-1 ratio of omega-6 to omega-3, meaning we have a very high inflammatory fat in our body and a very low amount of the good anti-inflammatory fat that should be in our bodies. So one of the best ways to increase it is getting the right kinds of fish. But the omega-3s do a bunch of stuff on the ketogenic diet. Okay, they're gonna help upregulate neurogenesis. So they're gonna help grow new brain cells. They're gonna add an additional layer of neuronal protection. So basically what they do is they support the cell membrane. So it not only makes the cell stronger, but it improves what's called cell fluidity. So it improves the ability of cells to communicate with each other and be able to move throughout their ecosystem a little bit better too. Additionally, they work with cytokines to actually bring inflammation down. So one of the things that omega-3s have been shown to do is actually reduce what is called cyclooxygenase enzymes. Okay, so COX enzymes or cyclooxygenase enzymes are the same things that we're trying to reduce when we take an aspirin. Okay, that's a COX inhibitor, COX inhibitor. So when we can actually reduce COX enzyme activity by taking in omega-3s, we can reduce inflammation within the body and therefore reduce some pain, which can help us out on a ketogenic diet. But as far as fat loss is concerned, we have to look at the uncoupling protein 1 factor. Omega-3s improve uncoupling protein 1. Okay, this means that the body has the ability to take dormant, just storage fat, and turn it into metabolically active brown fat that actually improves thermogenesis, increases our core body temperature, and encourages our body to burn more fat. We're taking storage fat and turning it into active fat. All right, so now let's get into the list without further ado. First up is going to be sardines. If you watch my videos, you know I'm a fan of sardines. I talk about them quite frequently. They're nice because you can get them in a can and even still be paving the way to a healthier ketogenic lifestyle. See, the cool thing about sardines is they are arguably one of the highest omega-3 rich foods that you can even eat on land and in sea. So period, they're just awesome. 740 milligrams of docosahexaenoic acid, which is specific for your brain, and about 350 to 450 milligrams of eicosapentaenoic acid, which is just great for overall whole body inflammation reduction. But additionally, super, super high in selenium. Okay, selenium is critical for thyroid function, specifically for women. Very, very powerful for women who tend to have a little bit of a drop in thyroid function when they first start the ketogenic diet. Something very important to know about sardines: do not get them in oil, get them in water. If you get the sardines in oil, they're gonna be drenched in a soy oil or a canola oil, which is gonna end up counteracting the entire benefit of the healthy fats that are in the sardines in the first place. So get them in water. That way you can control the fats that are coming into your body on the ketogenic diet a lot better. Okay, number 2 is gonna be mackerel. Now, mackerel you can get fresh Or again, you can get it in a can as long as it's BPA free. Nice thing about mackerel, also still very, very high in omega-3s. We're still looking about 1,000 milligrams per typical serving. Now, it is skewed slightly towards the eicosapentaenoic side, so a little bit less in the DHA side, less on the brain side and more on the whole body inflammation side, but still very, very powerful for the body on a ketogenic diet. One of the things I like most about mackerel and why it's on my list is that it is one of the highest natural sources of bioavailable vitamin D and vitamin A. Okay, we're talking over 350 IUs in a 100-gram serving. Okay, now true bioavailable vitamin D. We're not talking about a synthetic vitamin D that you get in a supplement. We're talking about true bioavailable vitamin D that can actually be used for your immune system. We're also talking about vitamin A, like true retinol form A, which has got a pro-resolving mediator effect. So it helps balance out all kinds of inflammatory processes within the body. Now, when you're first starting out on a ketogenic diet, your immune system can get a little bit suppressed because you're throwing a wrench in a lot of what your body's used to. So the vitamin D in a true bioavailable form can actually help out your body's T cells. T cells go through your body and they hunt down illnesses, they hunt down sicknesses and prevent them from ever causing a problem. Very, very important. So I highly recommend mackerel if you're starting out on a ketogenic diet. But big warning, do not go for king mackerel. Big, big, big warning. Okay, also do not go for Spanish or do not go for Gulf mackerel. These forms of mackerel have a lot of toxins in them and they're generally lower in the omega-3 values as well. So don't go for those. You're gonna wanna go for the North Atlantic mackerel, which quite frankly is most of what you'll find in the cans anyway. But just be very, very careful, especially if you're going fresh on the mackerel. Next up is gonna be one you've probably heard of before, but I'm gonna explain a little bit more. Wild caught salmon. Okay, I can't overemphasize this enough. Wild caught salmon in a sockeye form is one of the best forms of omega-3 that you can get in a larger fish. Do not, under any circumstances, go for the farm-raised salmon, okay? It's not so much about the toxins, I mean, that's terrible, but it's more about what they're actually feeding these salmon that are coming from a farm source. See, they just feed them a pellet that basically has no nutrients in it, that just helps them grow and helps them be fat so that you just end up with a lot of meat. That's not what we want. That kills the entire omega-3, omega-6 value. In fact, farm-raised salmon have about 2,000 milligrams of omega-6s, whereas wild-caught salmon has about 300 milligrams of omega-6s. Remember, omega-6s are the bad one. So we have a ton of omega-6s in the farm-raised salmon. Also, tons and tons of antibiotics. And that red color, that's not a natural red color. That's added to make it look like they have what's called astaxanthin, which is a very powerful antioxidant that gives salmon its true red color. So the reason I recommend sockeye as a wild-caught salmon is because sockeye is actually leaner. And if you go for the leaner fish, even though you're going for the omega-3s, you give yourself more flexibility and less potential for damage. So go for the leaner fish in this case because you're gonna be able to have more potency with your protein, more potency with the astaxanthin, that antioxidant profile, and you can just add your fats with coconut oil. So by now you've watched my videos and you know that I'm a fan of ButcherBox. ButcherBox is literally probably one of the only places that you can get grass-fed, grass-finished meat delivered to your door, literally cheaper than the grocery store. But now they brought something else to the table. They knew that I was a big proponent of wild-caught sockeye salmon. So what did? They now have wild-caught sockeye salmon that is flash frozen right after it's caught in Bristol Bay, Alaska. So you're getting the highest quality sockeye salmon with the highest quality omega-3s, literally flash frozen as soon as it's caught, and now you're able to get this delivered to your door in your butcher box. So right now they're offering a special where there's 2 pounds of Pacific sockeye salmon added to your ButcherBox. So if you go ahead and you click on the link that's down below in the description, you can check them out. And a huge thank you to ButcherBox for helping make this video possible and helping make it so this channel can put out amazing content. So make sure you check that out in the link down in the description after you watch this video. All right, moving on, we have halibut. The reason I put halibut on the list is because it is a relatively lean fish that still has the flavor and consistency of a fattier fish. Because of its texture, it kind of has a buttery taste, but it's actually quite lean. And one of the things that I really like about halibut is that it doesn't absorb a lot of the toxins. It doesn't absorb a lot of the stuff that's in the water just by its very nature and its very texture. So it's a very clean fish and also a very lean fish, but it's very, very, very important. And one of the reasons I put it on this list is so that I can bring clarity to which halibut not to get. Do not get Atlantic halibut. Okay, Atlantic halibut is known for being very high in PCBs and very high in heavy metals. Okay, it is a larger fish, which means that it's higher up the food chain, so normally it wouldn't be on my list. But Alaskan halibut or Pacific halibut is very, very good for you. Obviously, it's got that high omega-3 profile, it's relatively inexpensive, and it tastes amazing. Okay, lastly, I had to throw this one in here because I wanted to give something to all my viewers that live in a little bit more of an interior area that might have some lakes. You see, rainbow trout is actually really, really good. So rainbow trout is on my list simply because it is still one of the highest omega-3 values that you're gonna find in a larger fish. And it's a fish that you can usually get from a lake source. Now, the thing that we have to remember with lake-sourced fish is that it widely depends on what lake you got it from. Okay, you need to look at your local area and know if your lake is known for having a lot of toxins in it. I highly recommend getting rainbow trout from a stream or from a lake that doesn't allow recreational boating. That way you're not having a bunch of exhaust and a bunch of toxins in there. That's gonna be very, very important. But rainbow trout is very high in eicosapentaenoic acid and also very high in docosahexaenoic acid, both the omega-3s that you need for your brain. But one of the things I like most about trout and any lake fish in general, if you can find a good quality one, is it's usually gonna have a higher mineral content. Okay, usually it's gonna have higher levels of the magnesium and the potassium that you need, which is very, very important on a keto diet. So if you're living in an interior area and it's harder to get fresh fish from the ocean, you can rely on trout whenever you need it. So there you have it. These are the five top fish that I'd recommend on a keto diet. Obviously, I could expand this list, and if you want me to, I will. But I wanted to make sure I at least summarize the top five that I think are gonna help your ketogenic lifestyle rev up to the max so you can burn more fat and feel more amazing. I'll see you in the next video.